Okay, welcome back to another episode of the Developer's Perspective Let's Play. This is Dell, and a new version came out last weekend, so I had to go and clear all of the stages that I had previously cleared because the save file is not compatible anymore. And there is also a few new stages like this one, House of the Damned. And let's take a look. I noticed that this stage, they forgot to include the music file for it, so it has no music, and because of that, let's play our own music for it. This is not the official track, but it's a track that I like from Blaster Master and the PlayStation 1. And also, we are switching to use Roll for this stage. After this stage, we are going back to the Brimstone Factory because it was changed. The design was improved. This is a new suite for Roll. I'm not sure what it does. Oh, it throws a bomb with a cherry shot. Okay. This is Eri from Metal Slug. And we lost it already. Well, at least we got to see what the suit does. So, this looks like yet another Doom stage, but it has some of the enemies. I'm not sure, I think those enemies are from Metal Slug, but I remember that they were in the old Raccoon City stage. They are supposed to be like some kind of special operations guys, so that's probably why they are in hell with us in this Doom stage. I like the design of this stage. I think that there's also some new bosses in World 1. I don't know if any of them is in the stages that I already went through. If anybody knows, let me know so I can go and take a look. I left World 1 before we got into any of the ice stages. So it looks like this stage is faithful to the typical Doom stage with the school doors. Oh, that's a new design for the poison mushroom. we got this suite again. It's pretty good. And it looks like this stage includes a secret exit. But I took a look to the map earlier and the secret stage behind this one is Blocks of Doom. Which means that Blocks of Doom is once again a secret stage. But we already did that stage before, so I'm not going back to it. No need to get the secret exit. Okay. And that's it for this stage. It was nice, nice design. Very straightforward. Yeah, when I use the cheats to clear the secret, I mean, when I use the cheats to clear the stages from the map, all of the secret exits were also unlocked. But I want to find the secret exit on this stage on the normal way. Somebody told me that the secret stage in this level is in the water area. So that's where we will be going. That's a new effect for this guy. And he's just taking all of my rupees. Nice, the bat suit. Also, they changed it. Roll can now walk while she's shooting. In the previous versions, you had to stop walking in order to shoot. So let's try and find the secret exit. It should be a wall we can walk through. Probably. Oh, there it is. Yeah, it's quite simple. So that unlocks this path to the Bulkmire's Inferno. This stage is based on the Battletoads game and it was made by Lars Ulrich. Oh, there is also Sonic. Sonic got new sprites. Because the old ones were too large. I'm not sure that's what that enemy used to be. It was probably changed. Because of a glitch, maybe? I think that this purple enemy is from the Altered Beasts arcade game. This is a fine stage, except since it's auto-scrolling, if we die we have to go through it all over again at the same speed. That's the only thing that most people do not like about the auto-scrolling stages. This gun we were using was the nail gun. I made that gun for the Quake stage, and it's designed after the nail gun from Quake 4, I think. This area is a typical, I don't know what it's called. It's not a speedrun, it's like a endurance obstacle race something. The Battletoads games have a lot of this. That item we have in the reserve box is a blue shield. It's only meant to let Sonic take one extra hit, like Mario Mushroom. It doesn't do anything special. Oh, by the way, this video will be longer than the previous ones, because I am taking some days off my work, so I have some extra time today. I was thinking about making more videos, like 30-minute videos, and record all of them today, but for me it's easier to just continue. If it's too long, you guys can just watch 30 minutes or something and then continue watching later. And this is the first time I take some days off my work, 2 weeks, in like 1.5 years. Because for those that don't know, and most of you probably don't have a reason to know where I work. Oh, that nice, this unlocks the Red Switch Palace. I work at forensics in Mexico, like with the DNA evidence in criminal cases. And there is a lot of crime in Mexico, so plenty of work for me. all the time. My job also includes the identification of dead bodies that are often in conditions where they aren't recognizable by their relatives, so we have to use the DNA databases. And yeah, that's what I do, and that's why I'm always busy. I suggested to make this snake vulnerable to the ice bullets, and it was done, actually. It was changed. So now we can kill it with ice. In the previous video where we went to this stage, it was immune to ice. It looks like we got a lot of rupees in Volkmeyer's Inferno. We have almost 2,000 now. So we are switching back to Protoman. And we will buy off all of the upgrades and try not to die. We don't have any of the weapons for Protoman yet. And there it is. Oh, I forgot that Brimstone Factory was also redesigned. So let's take a look. My feedback on it the last time was that it was too long, a little repetitive, and that they only gave you the guns after most of the enemies were already killed. But it looks like that was the case because we were using Protoman, and we were able to kill most of the enemies with him. But if we had a different character like Mario, we will need to go to get the guns and then come back to kill the enemies. So there's that. I see that they added a lights out special effect to the stage, so it looks a lot darker. Something that fits the Doom atmosphere. So it was a nice idea to do that. Yeah, this stage is a lot better now. Okay, very big improvement. I don't think that those red guys used to shoot lightning before. Or at least I didn't see them in the last time we played. I'm not sure what game those are from. We have to kill all of the enemies, so let's take our time. Also trying to collect the red coins for once. I'm liking this stage a lot more. And we need to be careful. These guys are a lot more dangerous now because we cannot see them before they shoot. So we have to look out. Yeah, that's nice. We also cannot see the lost souls before they charge at you. This lights out effect definitely changes things. Let's use this weapon to get rid of this guy. Dangerous. That's not a good enemy placement for that lost soul, because we cannot see it. So if you are using a character that cannot stomp, that's a hit you're going to take for sure. And I would suggest moving that lost soul a little to the left, so you can see it coming at you. We got the Magnet Man weapon now, so that's gonna be useful to get rid of these guys first. Yeah, you see, now I know that the Lost Soul is right there. And that's why it's so difficult to design the stages for MKF, because you have so many different characters. Some of them cannot stomp, others do not have projectiles, and all of them need to be able to deal with the enemies. And you need to be very careful where you place them in a stage, and you need to include methods for the characters to fight the enemies also. For example, if we were using Mario and we had no power-ups, we would require the guns and also these bombs to deal with the enemies, because some of them cannot be killed by stomping. And if we are using Protoman, who cannot stomp, we need to be careful where we place the enemies so it's not on fire for him. We need the anti-knockback item. We got a lot of rupees, so welcome. We are going to get the anti-knockback. And what's this? This is new. You. Oh, you can pick up the SMB2 style items faster. It's a little expensive, I think, for what it does. It's fine. I'm going to go ahead and get an Elecman. Actually, no. I want this one. This is a shop exclusive weapon.
Come back anytime.
And that's the torpedo weapon from the Octopus from Mega Man X1. It's like a heat-seeking projectile, which is very useful for this stage. Because we cannot see the enemies. It uses a lot of ammo to balance it out. But it's still a great weapon. And let's try not to die this time. Podobus first. Here we go. Nice, there's a hidden rocket launcher in here. The problem with the rocket launcher is that the explosion is so large that you usually end up hitting yourself. And because the enemies in this stage are invisible until you get close to them because of the lights out effect. A rocket launcher is probably not the best choice. I hit myself twice right there. Which is why I would probably change that rocket launcher for a raid gun. The raid gun from Quake 2. It's already in the game. But it's safe to use. Did we miss? Well, no, never mind. There's the door. And that's it. So yeah, this stage was improved a lot. I like it. I would only change that lost soul placement. And the rocket launcher for a railgun. So this is where we left the last episode. Sanctum of Torment. This is a new stage for me. I have not played it before. It was not in the older versions. And it looks like it's a stage based on the Castlevania. I remember these things. I think they used to be in one of the old Game Boy Castlevania games. So it's nice to see that there is not only Doom and original stages being added to the game, also crossover ones like before. The music is very atmospheric. I need to get some HP because I do not want to lose my anti-knockback item. So this is where the enemies from the laboratory area from the Raccoon City stage were reused. Nice, finally got some HP. There is also the liquor skin of President Evil on the Goombas. So this is probably meant to be also a Resident Evil crossover stage, maybe. Let's take those rupees. Nice. I didn't jump high enough. That's really fast. I'm liking this stage, it's fun. Not sure about the music though. I like when the levels and the video games have catchy soundtracks. This one is very atmospheric. Nice, I got hit. I guess we need to go down there. Yeah, I think we need to go all of the way back up. There is the last red coin up there. I'm not sure if I should go and try to grab it. Ah, we got my HP, so yeah, I'm going. We can slide anyway. Yeah, I'm not sure this part is possible. Anyway. Continue. This could be a lot harder if we were using a character that cannot kill the armored enemies, but Protoman can with the charge shot. I think we need to go down there, yes. And a checkpoint, nice. Close one. So there is a lot of different enemies in this stage. There's Castlevania, there is Ghosts and Goblins, there is a Zelda but I think their name is Kiss. There's Resident Evil enemies. Yoshi Island. But all of them fit somehow. I am guessing that this stage is going to have a boss later, but not yet. Yeah, that was a good stage. I liked it. Anyway, let's continue. We are almost done with World 4. Let's switch characters. I want to use I don't know why Violence Zero can be picked. I have not unlocked them yet. And I have the debug mode off, so I'm not sure if that's a glitch. You know, let's go and take this one. I did use the debug mode to clear the stages to get back into this world, but I did not unlock Zero and Bile. This stage is also new for me. Oh nice, it's auto-scrolling, we have to be quick. It looks like another original stage that uses World Force enemies, I think. I do not recognize that enemy. The sprites, where it's from. There is also no skin on the question blocks in the stage. I do not recognize the music either, so if you know what game this is based on, let me know. We need to be extra careful with Luigi because of his classic controls. And I do not like that enemy from Castlevania, the ghost, because it appears out of nowhere. What killed me? I think I got crushed on the walls with the screen scrolling. I was trying to get the power up, but I did not see any walls. Oh well, let's try again. That's when the game just decides to kill you. Like, you're doing fine, just die. it takes three stumps to kill that guy. I thought it would be only two. I hit the game by that thing. That enemy is very difficult to avoid. I would probably make it. Ah, damn it! That wall is solid. It does not look like it's solid. Yeah, that boss enemy should probably appear a little slower so you can see it coming. Oh, that was a glitch. With Luigi sprites. When small Luigi picks up an item, it has a black square behind. So yeah, that's a visual glitch. It was probably not reported before because nobody uses this guy. Yeah, on this tile set, visually it looks like only the brown skulls should be solid and not the black ones. The black ones look like part of the background. I don't know if they were solid in the original game. But that's what I think. Like these black ones right here, it doesn't look like they should be solid. They are. Ah, fuck it. It hit me again, but this time it was my fault. Okay, we got through that part finally. That's a nice use of the power block. And that's it. That was not easy at all. Nice again. But I'm not a fan of enemies that appear out of nowhere. Okay. We need to use that shell to kill everyone. Thank you. making some big plays right there. This is not easy at all. This is really long. I'm not sure about that enemy placement. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Wait, how am I supposed to kill that guy? Small Luigi cannot stomp him. So that's also a flaw in the design of the stage, which means that I cannot clear it with Luigi. We did so good, but that last enemy should not be there. Let's try and use Arthur this time. I played it so good in there. And then I had to die because of an enemy that Luigi cannot kill. Okay. Yeah, this is going to be a lot easier now. That was such a bummer. Classic Luigi was going so well, and at the end, there's that guy. What? Why didn't he get into the platform? Okay. Yeah, this stage is difficult. I feel bad for poor classic Luigi. Arthur's jumps are so small. You need to double jump almost on every platform. Yeah, I was doing better with Luigi. Not sure how did those Koopas end up in here. In hell. But I'm glad they did because of the shells. I like that this stage is the last one before the world boss. It fits because of its difficulty. It's also a nice effect that it gets darker. Okay, so we go to this part. Like, if I'm Luigi... Oh, so that was not the end of the stage. No, it is. Oh, never mind. We just needed to get higher. I cannot kiss him. There. So never mind, we almost did this, Luigi, but... I try to stomp him, and it turns out that you can't. Oh, so we got Astaroth. This guy was supposed to be a boss in this world for a long time, but Obrecht, the developer, disappeared before he could get into it. It's nice to see that he's finally here. Nice. Yeah, I like this stage a lot. It's difficult, it's well designed. It's very difficult, this stage. Let's switch characters for the world boss. Let's try Waluigi. This is a new character for me, I have never used him. I understand that he's like a Wario clone. With a few differences. On the suits and his speed. Just like Mario and Luigi are different. Also, Waluigi cannot butt stomp like Wario. Thank you. I want to see what his other power-ups are for Waluigi. But so far we only have gotten the soccer suit. Oh, this is the vampire. Yeah, this one is a straight clone of the Wario one. No differences. I always lose the new suits as soon as I get them. You know, at some stage of the MKF development, that guy we just beat, but the other version, the one that's called Firebrand, that has its own game, Demon Crest, was going to be a playable character in MKF. We even had all of the sprites for him. But again, since Obrek, the lead developer of that time, just disappeared, and since he was the only one who knew how to code characters, that idea was also scrapped. Lots of enemies right here. Oh my god. Yeah, I can see why a lot of people say that this game is too difficult. Sometimes. Ah, fucker. I cannot hit him. Yeah, I cannot stop that guy, so I had to try and jump, but it was spikes underneath. Let's try again. The only character that I really wanted to be in the game was Crash Bandicoot. I even tried to get sprites for him to work with. And at some point Obrek also agreed to make him a playable character. He was going to have the spin kick to work like Sonic. Like Sonic Dashes in the game's coding wise, talking about. He was going to have a slide like Simon's that can defeat enemies, a double jump, and a Goomba fruit bazooka. Along some other power-ups, but again, Obrek just disappeared and all of those ideas were never implemented. There was also going to be Doom Guy as a secret character. He was going to be a really simple guy, not difficult to code actually, because he was not going to have any suites of upgrades. The Doom guy was only going to have a lot of the Doom and Quake weapons already available for him to use, and he would be able to switch between the weapons freely. And the only thing that he would get in the power-ups would be ammo. Ammo to use all of his weapons. He would have the shotgun, the nail gun, the lightning gun, the rail gun, the rocket launcher. And using any time. He would be able to stomp. We had lots of ideas back then. Some of them were not very difficult to implement at all. But that's what happens when in a team only one or two people know how to do things in the game. Most of the team, we were only able to code a few things and work on level design. But coding was a whole new concept. So we got a new suite. This is the Foreman Luigi suite. It's the Hammer Bro equivalent. And I see that he throws a very heavy hammer. Nice. It's pretty strong. That enemy was always the most difficult one to deal with, even in the original Ghouls and Goblins games, because he's so unpredictable. Only in this game you can save the world by throwing vegetables. Looks like we got to the boss. Yeah, this is Loki from the Ghosts and Goblins games. Ghosts and Ghouls, whatever it is. There is the intro. And his design should be pretty faithful to the original one. He shoots lasers at you with his hands and then with his feet. He tries to stomp you. I think it's two or three phases in this boss fight. It starts getting difficult, because he starts shooting faster. And there is also more enemies spawning. I can also hit him directly on the head. So there goes the second platform. And this is as difficult as it gets, and we probably will not make it. But let's try. I think the fire reached me. Nice, good hit already. If we die, I'm going to use Classic Luigi for some redemption. Back in the days of the old forums, we had a thread about MKF challenges, like defeat this stage or beat this boss with Classic Mario, Classic Luigi. And at some point we thought about having those challenges implemented in the game as well. So perhaps the idea could still be implemented by the team. It's up to them. But it would be nice, like defeating a stage with a certain character or something like that. Beat a stage without shooting anything as Mega Man, or don't beat any of the enemies. Stuff like that. Okay, we are almost done. There it is. I want to go into the Quake stage, but we need to find the Blue Switch Palace first. And I think that it's in World 6, I'm not sure. So let's get to the World 6 secret exit and see if the switch is in there. If it's not, we will skip to World 9. And that's the first world boss and the first key. And let's go back to World 1. Let's also not forget to save the game. And let's continue where we left. World 1. Which is the ice world. And I do not want to take a lot of time beating these stages. So let's switch back to Protoman. And also we need to get to the ship. Where is the ship? There it is. Let's again get the anti-knockback and beat. Because World 1 has a lot of beats. So a beat is good to have to save you from those. And here we go. Frosty Flight. See? A lot of bits already. I don't remember, but I think this stage is not new at all. It was always there. And that glitch still exists. Like the black ball from that plant enemy just flies up. I don't remember if that's what it was like in Super Mario 3 also. Oh, I see. So we need a fire weapon and the P-switch to get into that pipe. We will try that next time. I think that I like the original version of this music than this remix. Yeah, definitely I do. Yeah, this stage is very old. I think it was made by one of the very old contributors from many years ago. I think, I'm not sure, that it was made by Captain Cook. I don't know if he's still around or not. Captain Cook was a strange person sometimes. Very random. But he did some nice contributions to the game. Like a few stages and coding. There was also Magnemania. don't know where did he go. He was on the Discord channel for some time, for a while, and then he disappeared. It looks like this stage was redesigned a little. It uses different tile sets. Yeah, it looks better than before. New design also. We should probably go and get Fireman's weapon to melt those blocks. Oh, nice. We got it right away. Let's see what do we do here? I don't know. Did I miss something? I cannot go back, so I guess I have to jump and see what's under. Ah, yeah. This torpedo weapon is overpowered, but that's why it's a shop exclusive. I wonder if we can melt this. No, we can't. Nice, the black hole. There it is. That was a nice stage. Frozen Plateau. This is also one of the oldest stages, and I see that it was also redesigned. I feel like I say the same thing on every single stage that I play. But actually, it looks like the design is still the same, mostly, I think. But it has different music and different tiles. How do I get in there? Did I miss something? Oh, there it is. The stage is the same as always. Just different tiles and music. So much has changed on this game that it feels strange to play an old stage instead of a new one. And next is the Ice World Fortress, and that's where the secret exit is to get into World 6. And this is Frost Palace. Oh, so this used to be called Nighttime Ice Capades, I think. It was made by Shodian. And the actual fortress was made by Genisi back then. Nice to see that this nighttime ice capades was not removed from the game. I thought that it was. And I'm glad that it's still in the game, because this was always my favorite, one of my favorite World 1 stages. It was very short, but nice to see that it's still in the game. I do not know where the secret exit is. Where's the platform? There it is. So we will have to find out. Ooh, that was close. Ah, it's the lightning wave. Yeah, this is a new design. It looks like Genesis' old design was removed from the game. And I'm kind of glad that that's the case, I did not like the old one very much. Oh, here's the secret exit. So we need a fire weapon. I think that we will just try and clear the stage normally. See if we can get a fire weapon. If we can't, we will switch to Wario, because Wario has the dragon cap. I don't know why we were given stomp boots for this. We don't have to stomp anything. Maybe they will put a Koopaling in here, which you need to stomp. But right now, there is nothing to stomp. So we will switch to Wario. And try not to lose the dragon cap before we get to that part. Oh, so we keep the sweets that we had as Waluigi. Here it is. And we will keep it in reserve, just in case. There is the butt stomp that Waluigi cannot perform. That's a Wario unique ability. Alright, we got another. Let's try not to lose them. Fuck. Okay, we are almost there. Nice, another one. Okay, we made it, so let's melt this and get into the pipe. Some frozen enemies, this is new. I wonder if we can melt them? No. I don't know if they can hurt me, let's see. Yes, they can. And I should probably not have tried that, in case we need the fire. Okay, we got another one. Ah, this guy moved me. So I'm guessing that all of these enemies will wake up suddenly, or is it just... Never mind. They are permanently frozen. Still, this is an interesting design. The music is a little loud, so we will lower it. Nice. This is where the new enemies begin, and the fusion. I don't remember what the name of this game. This stage is based on is called. All I remember is that it was made by Gladia Cloud. I used to know the name, but I forgot. This has been in the game for a while. And World 6 is all about fantasy. Fantasy themed games like Final Fantasy, some of the Zelda stages. And I have never been a fan of fantasy games, so I don't know the source of a lot of them. But World 6 is also where the Dracula Castle is. That's the world boss stage that I made, and it's my best work on this game. It's a very long and very complex stage with Dracula and everything. A lot of new enemies and areas, and the stage was just so long. And why isn't this flame moving? But the Demon Realm War 4 already had a world boss being Loki, so there was no room for Dracula. And World 6 never got a world boss of its own, because World 6 was always difficult to work with. Most of the fantasy games and things like Final Fantasy, Zelda, and Secret of Mana and other stages never had any real sprites to work on a 2D platform game. So it's required for us to make custom sprites. I see that there's a new world map. That's nice. So making a Warboss stage was difficult, and we had the Dracula one, so we decided to use it in here. You could say that it doesn't fit, and it probably doesn't fit very well. But we can always just some use story and make the plot, adjust the plot to make it work. Because I believe that a game should be done first, and then you can implement the plot, the story, and not the other way around. For a game like this, anyway. Where you need to find a lot of resources. This stage used to be called Verdant Plain, and it was in World 2 before it was moved to World 6. I think that was a checkpoint. The owl statue. Let's see what's in the chest. Just coins. I'm not sure, but I think that the rupees on the stages were also rebalanced, because I remember that a lot of stages had too many rupees after World 1, and you could get a lot of them very quickly. But I see that that's not the case anymore. We don't have too many. If you want to unlock Zero or some of the future unlockables for the shop, you have to grind them. Since the map was changed, I cannot see all of it yet, so I don't know if the blue switch is in here. So we need to clear some more stages. Land of Lattice, I don't remember what the game it's based on is called anymore. But it's a very chill stage, I like it. This one was made by Obrek. I see that the music was changed. I don't know if this is the original one or a remix. And back in the day, it was not common of Obrecht to make a stage. He would mostly gold the enemies, but when it got to designing the stages, it was other people who did it. Obrecht, however, took his time to make some levels of his own, and it was some of the best ones back in that day, because since he knew how to code so many things, he could make his own bosses and enemies. And that's why we got some stages like this and the Energy Zone, which is a Contra stage in World Name. But yeah, most of the time it was us making stages and Obrecht coding. You could say that part in the team has not changed, because now we have Dookie is like the new Obrecht. He is the lead and he codes stuff, enemies, and fixes things, but he doesn't get into level making. I think that, yeah, this is a glitch. Let's try to work around it. Yeah, with the lightning web. So if we do this, we can get stuck in this area. Like this. We will need to exit the stage. Thankfully we have the lightning web to get out. It doesn't work anymore. I shouldn't have to walk back into this area. Yeah, I think I'm stuck. Well, we will use some cheating. Let's turn the debug mode on for a second and use this tool to move me a little on this platform. There it is. And let's continue. This video is going to be very long, and I'm not sure if I will get the time to find the exact screenshot to post on the box section of the Discord channel, so if anybody can help me with that, I would appreciate. Take a screenshot and describe the glitch and post it. Taxman is watching these videos, so he can probably take a look himself, but just in case. Thank you. We could use some help. I think there's only one more room. Yeah, this is the last one. Under this. It's a nice stage. Let's see the new battle encounters for this world. This enemy is new, I have no idea what it is or where it's from. Like I say, I never really played most of the fantasy theme games during my childhood, so the only Final Fantasy game that I played was Final Fantasy IX on the PS1, and that's it. Did we miss one enemy? I thought we got all of them. Okay, that was weird. I have no idea. Let's see what stage is next. Fillmore Guild. I think that... Ah, damn it, we lose the torpedo weapon. This stage... Again, I forgot what the name of the original source is. But it uses the music from Super Mario RPG. I think that this stage used to have a different music. It was the original music from the game this stage is based on. If I only could remember. Was it... No, I don't remember. I need to look it up. But the music from the original game that this stage used to use was also very sticky. I could probably change it back, because this is not a Mario RPG stage. It's a stage based on that game. It's a crossover stage. So this soundtrack. Is a little unfitting, in my opinion. I mean, it fits the theme, but the game had its sound. Ah, damn it! No, nice, we had beat. Oh, I see some of the black rupees. They are the negative rupees. They take away your own rupees. And this key is for a secret exit, but we will not get into that yet. Let's try to get the one up. I don't remember what the game was called. It was arcade something, I think. I don't remember. Forest Temple. Yeah, this is a Zelda stage. Nice, I see that it got some new effects. This one was made by Gladia Cloud, I think. Or was it Aura? I don't remember. I like the visual effects that the stage got. World 6 has improved a lot since its older versions. In the very, very, very first versions of MKF, World 6 was supposed to be a shmups world, a shoot-em-up world, based on games like Gradius and all of those games where you had a ship, that genre of games, like Gradius. And that was because Judge Spear was a fan of that kind of game. But it felt like it was a concept that would not work for MKF. And so World 6 was changed to be a fantasy world instead. We still got a Gradius stage, which I made actually, in World 9. You have the ship and everything. But that gimmick, having one stage is enough of it. A whole world was too much. So I think that we need to take this rock back to the other statue. Yeah, that unlocks the key. Okay, that was weird. So this is a Zelda type of bomb. That forest armor is from Castlevania Circle of the Moon, and that was also one of the enemies that I coded for the game. Well, I only fixed it actually. It was Gladia who first tried to code it, but it was very messy at first. And that enemy has been used on a lot of stages since then. I think that Castlevania game, Circle of the Moon, was one of the best ones in the whole franchise. But it's very underrated. Everybody's favorite Castlevania game is always the Symphony of the Night one, and that's probably because it was the first one of the Castlevania games that had the whole Metroidvania concept on it. But personally, I do not like that game a lot. I like the later ones more. Like Area of Sorrow on the Game Boy Advance was also one of the best. Harmony of Dissonance. But yeah, Circle of the Moon was my favorite. I just remember that for the little time that I came back to the development team back in 2018 when MKF was resurrected, I just remember that I also made the boss for this stage. I had forgotten. You will see it soon. I don't even know what it's called. I just got the request from Foster to code it, and I did. Nice, we need a key. Yeah, that's the thing with this kind of stitch. It's like a maze. So we need to find the key. These guys. Oh, never mind, it's just the rock for the statue. There we go. We need one more key. Oh, here it is. And it's blocked by some bricks, I guess. Yeah, this is a switch. A little redundant having the switch right next to it. But it works. I think that the stage is almost over. And this should be the boss, yeah. Yeah, this is the guy. We need to kill the Skulltulas first. Yeah, I don't even remember my own bosses. You have to find the real one before it shoots. I think that's all it does. That's what it was like in the original game. Some Zelda game, I don't remember. I never played them. I only played one of the Zelda games. It was one of the Game Boy ones. It was great. One more hit. There it is. Yeah, it was a very simple and straightforward boss. Let's see what's next. Gerudo Valley. This is a new stage for me also. Looks like it's going to be a Zelda stage. I don't know what game it's from, but it's a Zelda thing. I think it's Ocarina of Time. Probably. I should probably have gone into the shop and purchase a bit for the bits. Yeah, this thing was a gimmick in the Fortress of Doom stage. I don't know if that stage is still in the game. It was very gimmicky. Yeah, this enemy is new. I think it's a Dodongo or something. What? I think that was a poison mushroom. Dodongo or something, I don't know. It's, I only know his name because of the memes back then. Okay, so we cannot hit that guy with any of the weapons. Yeah, poison mushroom. This is a fine stage also. It's good to see that War 6 got a lot of new content. Back in my day, I think that War 6 and War 7 were the most underdeveloped ones. What's next? Bugmuk Swamp. I have no idea what this is. It looks like it uses the design of the old Gemini Canyon stage. Maybe it was redesigned into this. It was a Gemini Wing stage, which was one of the shmoops stages that I was talking about. Oh, those are spikes. But the stage used to have a whole shmoop section with a ship, and then it turned into this kind of design. So it looks like Gemini Canyon was removed and this stage was put in place using the design of the old one. Not a bad idea, probably. We will take this skull shield because there is a lot of flying enemies around. There is some Tektites. I think that I liked the old music on this stage better than this. What? I thought we still have some hit points left. I like to go to the shop and buy some items, but the shops are too far. I think that in the future the shops will be implemented to be in the menu from the map, or at least that's something that Obrek wanted to implement at some stage. But it's up to Duki now to decide. He wants to keep the shops the way they are or change them. There is nothing wrong with the shops right now, it's just that you have to go back on the maps to find one, and it's just a little bit tedious to do so. Oh, that thing hit me again. This stage has a lot of books, enemies from many different games. I don't know if this world still has some of the Pokemon enemies, or if the Pokemon enemies were moved into World 8, which is the Nintendo subspace. Some of the Pokemons would probably fit in here. I'm not saying that they need to be done. This stage has enough different enemies already. Just saying that they would fit. What? Oh, there's the jelly. Use my shield. But I didn't notice that those spikes. A little difficult to see. Well, at least we got to a checkpoint. We'll take this path instead. There is too much shit above. Yeah, the skull shield is very useful in here. There's just so many flying enemies around that die with one hit. We need to go back so we can kill all of them. Running low on ammo. I wonder if the Walrus boss is still in this stage. Guess not. Maybe the Gemini Wing stage is still in the game. So many changes have been done. Concealed Chasm. What's this? This is also a new stage for me. I have no idea what this is based on. But judging from the enemies I see, it looks like one of those original stages that only get to reuse a lot of the assets in the game, but the game is not really based on anything. So it's not a crossover stage, it's just an original one that uses enemies from other stages. One of the reasons that they are probably doing this is also to reuse some of the parts of older stages that were removed from the game. Like this area right now. This is what used to be in the Dragon Dominion stage in World 4. Which was changed into Crimson Dominion. This is the first area of the stage. It was only modified a little. So that's why it has some enemies that we saw before in the Demon Realm. This stage used to be in there. So they took the stage, re-implemented it into a original one with some changes and different enemies. Thank you. It's a good way to reuse the content that was removed from the game, so it was not really removed, it's still there. Just on a different environment. Dragon Dominion was based on the Black Tiger game. Thank you. And you could say that game fits the Demon Realm but also World 6, because it's like a amalgam of fusion and, I mean, a fusion of fantasy and demon-like stuff. Ah, fucker. Can I swim in there? Oh, I think it bones, yeah. This part of the stage was also in the old Dragon Dominion stage, but it was modified to include this green goo. I'm liking the design. It's nice. And there it is. And it's been 2.5 hours. We will only clear the fire temple and call this a video. Oh. So yeah, this video probably accounts for like five of them. It's very long, I know, but you can take your time watching. So, Fire Temple was originally designed by Aura Lancer. But I think that it was improved since then. Let's see, likes. I'm not sure, but I think that those enemies, if they catch you, they make you lose a lot of rubies or even power-ups, or at least that's why they were meant to do. Okay, looks like we have to find the keys. And the different doors. And I have no idea why is it shaking so much. Okay, there's one key. And let's get the other. We only have one hit point left. And this guy's again. I think that the bombs should work, but he won't let me grab one. I wanted to see if I could kill it. Let's get into that door first and kill this bitch. Yeah, the bombs work. Thank you. so we can make him eat the bombs. I guess that's how you would kill them in the original Zelda games, I suppose. Damn it. I'm not doing so good. Okay, let's clear this stage once and for all. Because it's the last stage that we do for this video. Don't tell me that I forgot to get the key. Oh my god. I'm playing like a noob. Oh my god. This part is very difficult. I'm not sure it's possible for some of the characters to not get hit. Okay, there's the key. What? Wait. Oh, I see. I use the red key, but it's not permanent. I can only use it once, so I have to get it again. I would probably change those keys to be permanent, just in case some player makes a dumb play like I did. Okay. Nice. I like when these climbable objects are used. Oh, there's lava coming in, I can see. So we need to be quick. I think we got to the end of the stage. This should be the boss. Yeah. So he tries to dodge the gunshots. Is that supposed to happen? I don't know what's going on. I think that it glitched. Oh, I see him. It's off screen. Yeah, that's probably a glitch. I think that the boss has some kind of special attack when his HP is low, but it's not working properly. Yeah, we need to exit the stage and kill him real fast. So yeah, that's an important glitch that needs to get fixed. Need to kill him before he gets glitched. Need to take a look into its code to fix it. Oh, so the random encounters are still in the game. I thought that they were removed from the game because of the new battle encounters, but I see that the random ones are still in it. It's supposed to be like in Final Fantasy games where you are walking and something attacks you out of nowhere. Mount Saber, this is a stage made by Lars, and I see that the Water Temple is in it. And a waterfall. Maybe Gemini Canyon is still in the game. Let's find out later. Let's save the game of this really long video and call it done. So thank you all for watching. Help me out reporting the glitches you see. And leave some comments, please. Thank you.